With me in the studio is Diana Franklin from the Centre for German Jewish Studies at the University of Sussex. Hello, Diana, and thank you for coming.
Hello, yeah. Thank you for inviting me.
You're going to tell us about events that are organised for the Holocaust Memorial Day this year. What's the highlight?
So we have a very interesting programme. We always have an academic speaking first, and we have Richard Overy speaking first about the history of the Holocaust. We like to put it into context. Then after that, we have a very interesting combination of speakers. We have Anita Lasker-Wallfisch, who is now 95 years old. She is a survivor of Auschwitz and Bergen-Belsen. And she is going to be in conversation with Niklas Frank, who is the son of Hans Frank, who was the commandant and really responsible for the murder of the Jews of Poland.
So that's an incredible combination, a survivor and the son of the person who was really responsible for the killings of so many Jewish people.
It's quite an incredible thing that he is speaking. He has dedicated the last few years to speaking all over Europe about what his father did, and he's completely repudiated his father's reputation.
It must be quite a burden to live with, and obviously for her. How did she survive?
So she was taken to Auschwitz with her sister Renata. They had been forging material for French prisoners of war, and they were arrested for this, sent off to Auschwitz, and she survived because she was exceptionally good at the cello.
So what, if you're good at the cello, how does that make you?
They had an orchestra in Auschwitz, right, which is an incredible thing to imagine. In the midst of that horror.
And the orchestra was there to entertain the Nazi soldiers and people responsible of the camp?
It was responsible for playing, I think, most of the day. They played to try to create a pleasant ambiance, if you can imagine such a thing, in the concentration camp. And so while prisoners were being marched to their work, they would be playing, and they would be playing as they came back at the end of the day. They also gave concerts to the SS and their families.
And she was a young teenager,
yeah,
doing that,
yeah,
you know, witnessing all the horror. Yeah. And so today, in her mid-90s, she talks about it to people in the hope that people will hear the experience, learn from it.
She does. She was the leader of the cellos in the English Chamber Orchestra for many years. And I remember seeing her, a wonderful cellist, over many, many years. I would go to concerts, she'd be leading the cellos. She decided in the last 15 or so years, she came to Sussex to speak to us. When she first started speaking, Edward Timms, our former director, invited her to speak. And I think that was one of the first times she felt she had to tell people what she had experienced. I think she felt before it's too late, before this generation of survivors disappear, that they have to hear first-hand testimony of what happened.
And there's nothing like listening to people who are still here today, telling about their experience, and it is hoped learning from past experiences of hatred and racism, anti-Semitism. Is the event popular, and when is it, by the way?
So the event is Wednesday, the 6th of February.
Right, and are you expecting a lot of people, and how do people find out about it?
So we have a website where people can look up. If you look up University of Sussex, maybe you'll give the link at the end of this. You can book online, and we encourage people to come along. We're delighted, many, many schools bring their GCSE and A-level students.
Right. The theme this year is Torn from Home, and there's a very powerful picture of Arnold Tegani, the Jewish artist, on the cover. He's actually someone whose a lot of his pictures are kept at the Keep near the university, and we at Latest TV have a particular interest in him and hoping to cover more of his work.
I find his images incredibly powerful. Here on the front of our program, we have Nanina, his wife, looking out, full of anxiety, looking out to see if her husband Arnold will be returning. It's incredible, powerful. I feel that the message that we're hopefully bringing to many people this year in all the Holocaust education work that we're doing, not just Sussex, all over the country, is particularly important because of the atmosphere in the UK now, the atmosphere in America.
And around the world,
that people are somehow becoming more xenophobic again and saying we don't like the other.
Yes.
And I feel that if we can get the message across that people cannot be discriminated against just because they happen to be a different religion, a different colour,
it's
something we want to try to discuss.
Definitely. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you so much for inviting me.